What I've got here, I have got a Superegg. This is from the 1970s in this wonderful leather pouch that, you know, is very, very Game of Thrones. And out it pops. Even though it's an egg that stays up. Absolutely beautiful. Yeah, and it's a mathematical object, and the history of this object is fascinating. It's a great story, and it's also leads to some really quite good fun maths. So why don't I tell you the story? It all starts with Swedish town planners. And Swedish town planners, Sergels torg is a square, or it's actually not square, this is the problem, it was a rectangle in the middle of Stockholm, and they wanted to put a roundabout in it, okay? If they were going to put a circle, you know, you're wasting this space. No circle. If you put an ellipse, this is an ellipse. Here, it's too narrow. The traffic is going to get squashed. Couldn't do an ellipse. So they were thinking about what shapes they could use. And they end up asking this Danish guy, he was actually a poet and a mathematician, like an amazing Renaissance man called Piet Hein. And Piet Hein came up with a solution. And the solution was something called a super ellipse. I'm going to just start with the equation for a circle, x squared plus y squared equals 1. Okay, if this is 1, this is a circle. Let's play around with this, but let's enlarge the exponent. So let's go to x, say to the 4, plus y to the 4 equals 1. What this turns into, and these are actually called Lame curves, is that it gets a little bit fatter. It's a little bit fatter, okay? It's like it's becoming a square. So if we did the square, this is the square. It's becoming a little bit towards it. So, and I apologize for my rubbish writing. Let's go to x to the 8 plus y to the 8 equals 1. This looks, basically it looks like, you know, a baby bell cheese stuck in a box. If we were to go to, say, x to the infinity plus y to the infinity equals 1, it would be the square, okay? So by playing around with the exponent, it sort of puffs out and gets, approaches in the limit, the square.
Just squaring the circle.
Exactly. You could call it a squircle. Let's now start with an ellipse. This is a really rubbish ellipse. The equation for this is x over 3 squared plus y over 2 squared equals 1. And let's do exactly the same thing. If we were to turn this to a 4, it gets a bit chunkier. If we were to then turn it to an 8, it'd get even, it would be almost looking like the rectangle. So what Piet Hein, who had to try and find a shape for the traffic to go round in Sergels torg, is that he started, so just say here, this is the aerial view of Sergels torg, and he started with the ellipse, which, as I said before, couldn't do an ellipse, it's too narrow here, and he actually increased the exponent to get what he called a super ellipse. So the super ellipse is halfway in between the actual ellipse and the rectangle. And the exponent that he felt was both the most aesthetic and the most practical was 2.5. And it is true that this was then implemented, and Sergels torg, which is, it's got this kind of horrible kind of obelisk thing in the center, and at the moment it's right in the center of Stockholm. But more than that, this shape, it became an icon of 1970s design, and the Azteca Stadium, where the final of the World Cup was held, you look at the roof of the Azteca Stadium, that's a super ellipse. And there's loads of other Danish design that used this shape. And what Piet Hein discovered was that if he was going to make his super ellipse three-dimensional, it looked like this, and actually it was an ellipse, because obviously an ellipse would just fall over. It's got a peak thing. The super ellipse actually stands. Lame, a French mathematician, also did work on this. Sometimes they're called Lame curves, but now because Peter Hines is so famous, they would be called super ellipses.
This Numberphile video is made possible by the Mathematical Sciences Research Institute. But we'd also like to thank a special sponsor for this video, Audible.com. They are the leading provider of audiobooks and other spoken word publications. They have loads of stuff on their website, it's seemingly endless, and among them is actually the book Alex's Adventures in Numberland by Alex Bellos, who is the person you just watched in this video. And one of the best things about this audiobook is not only is it a brilliant best-selling book, but it's read by Alex himself, so you can hear him tell you all about it.
Entering the world of maths as an adult was very different from entering it as a child.
And yes, there is a whole bunch of stuff about super ellipses in this book. And if you want to look for some other mathematical reading, well, there's loads of stuff on Audible. So go to audible.com. In fact, if you go to audible.com/numberphile, they'll know you came from here, and you can also sign up for their 30-day trial, which lets you download a free audiobook, and you could make it Alex's Adventures in Numberland if you want, or one of the countless other ones they have available. Thanks to Audible for their support of this video.